Hello everybody, welcome this morning to this wonderful historic place, Whithorn, and to the morning service of the Pentecostal Holiness Church. And you'll be blessed, I'm sure. Welcome. Let's begin with intercession and prayer before the Lord, taking authority over all powers of darkness and proclaiming the precious and wonderful name of Jesus. Ora bashondora kiyama sokora maya. Shondora kiyama sondora kiyama shokiyara basondo. Shira kiyama sondora basondo kiyara bashobara. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow in heaven, on earth, and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Every tribe and every nation shall bow before him. Every tribe and every nation, people from every tribe and every nation, praise the Lord, shall and are and shall be with him in heaven, praising his holy name. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, we thank you, we praise you today with all of our hearts, all of our souls, all of our mind, and all of our strength. All believers united, all true church, true remnant church in every tribe and every nation, united in our praise and worship of the one true God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, three in one, the precious name of Jesus, being the name above all names, the name above every name, today. We praise and bless you. And today, as those of the earth, the powers and principalities and rulers of, in the world's eyes, the seven most powerful nations in the earth, in the natural sense, they are gathering, they have been gathering, in another Garden of Eden, just the same as at the very beginning when Adam and Eve and all the new creations of God gathered in the Garden of Eden. Same old serpent, same old evil entering into the Garden of Eden. And thus saith the Lord today, where is your power? Where is your greatness? Where is your authority? There is nothing given to you but by me, saith the Lord. As Jesus himself said to the Roman governor Pontius Pilate as he stood before him, and Pilate said, dost thou not know that I have the power to crucify you or to release you? And Jesus said, a dear Lamb of God about to be sacrificed on the cross for the sins of the world and to rise again on the third day. And he said to Pontius Pilate, there is no power given to thee except by God. Without God, you would have no power at all. And so it is with the great and powerful of the world. There will come a time when Jesus, having already returned to rapture his church, will return to the earth, and all the nations of the earth, which he created, will stand before him. And this is what will happen as we read in Matthew chapter 25. When Jesus discourses to his disciples about the end times. And we're reading here from Matthew 25, verse 31. when the Son of Man shall come to his glory, in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, in the Greek ethne, nations, tribes. And he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Because do you know, dear people, dear brothers, sisters, viewers, listeners, Jesus Christ is the Lamb slain from the very foundation of the world. And so there is a kingdom prepared for the sheep nations from the very beginning of the world. For I was an hungered, verse 35, and ye gave me meat. I was thirsty, and ye gave me drink. I was a stranger, and ye took me in. Naked, and ye clothed me. I was sick, and ye visited me. I was in prison, and ye came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee an hungered, and fed thee, or thirsty, and gave thee drink? When saw we thee a stranger, and took thee in, or naked, and clothed thee? Or when saw we thee sick, and were in prison, and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and say unto them, Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of these my brethren, ye have done it unto me. And all glory to God. We thank and praise and bless our Lord, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But especially today we're talking about the Lord Jesus as he judges the nations of the world. And we thank you, Father God, that you have prepared this place for the sheep, for those at your right hand who have shown true mercy and compassion to those in need, who have cared for and loved the babies and the children, the future of their nation, and who have cared for the old and the sick and the poor, and those imprisoned, and have shown mercy. Because God, you know, he sees all things. Nothing is hidden from the Lord. And he knows the sheep nations. Oh, we thank you, Father God, that even in these evil times of the last days, there are still those who are showing mercy. The most unlikely nations, sometimes the despised and rejected of the third world nations in Africa and South Asia and South America, where there is great persecution, but your church is growing. Oh, we thank you that nothing is hidden from you or from the prophets of God. Oh, we see it all now. And Lord, thank you for that great end time revival which thou hast promised among the nations. When you have said, preach the gospel to every creature, to all nations, and then the end shall come. These are thy very words. And from his word itself, he talks in Revelation, it talks about people of every tribe and every nation being saved, being in heaven with him. But woe to the goat nations, those who think they are so great and powerful and show no mercy and no fear of God. For the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. We are told that the fear of the Lord in the book of Proverbs is the beginning of wisdom. And oh, Father God, thou seest all things. Thou seest the goat nations and the wickedness that goes on there. listen to what is going to happen to them. Praise the Lord. We pray these words into being. We speak out his word today. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was an hungered, and you gave me no meat. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you took me not in. Naked, and ye clothed me not. Sick and in prison, and ye visited me not. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee an hungered, or a thirst, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister unto thee? Then shall he answer them, saying, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. Lord, thou seest these things. Thou seest the nations. You made the nations today. Father God, thou madest the whole earth. Thou madest tribes and nations, and we lift the whole earth. We lift those things to you today, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess him, King of glory now. 'Tis the Father's pleasure, we should call him Lord, who from the beginning was the mighty mighty and mysterious in the highest height, God from everlasting, very light of light, in the Father's bosom with the Spirit blessed, love in love eternal, rest in perfect rest. At his voice creation sprung at once to sight, all the angel faces, all the hosts of light, thrones and white dominions, stars upon their way, all the heavenly orders in their great array. Humbled for a season to receive a name from the lips of sinners, unto whom he came. Faithfully he bore it, spotless to the last, brought it back victorious when from death he passed. Bore it up triumphant with its human light, through all ranks of creatures to the central height, to the throne Well, this is At the Name of Jesus, and we've sung five verses, but did you know that there's actually more verses to it? There's actually 10 verses. So we're going to be carrying on in a minute, singing the other verses. So if you know the verses, the lyrics, do join in, won't you, at home?
Name him, brothers, name him, with love strong as death, but with awe and wonder, and with bated breath. He is God the Saviour, He is Christ the Lord, ever to be worshipped, trusted, and adored. In your hearts enthrone Him, there let Him subdue all that is not holy, all that is not true. Crown Him as your captain in temptations all. Let His will enfold you in its light and power. Brothers, this Lord Jesus shall return again with His Father's glory, with His angel train. For all wreaths of empire meet upon His brow, and our hearts confess Him King of glory now. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess Him King of glory now. 'Tis the Father's pleasure we should call Him Lord, who from the beginning was the mighty Word. Mighty and mysterious in the highest height, God from everlasting, very light of light. In the Father's bosom, with the Spirit blessed, love in love eternal, rest in perfect rest.
Beautiful hymn. Absolutely beautiful hymn. It says it all, and it's absolutely scriptural too, is it not? Dear viewers and listeners, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow.
Every tongue confess Him.
King of glory now.
You know, Lindsay, we are living in the very last of the last days. And absolutely, we're moving by the Spirit of God, moving in power, might, and dominion. And we're here today in the name of the Lord Jesus, casting out devils, healing the sick, and proclaiming that this is the year of the Lord's favor. And how we overcome, and everyone in business knows this, is to know what your opponent is doing.
Mm-hmm.
There is no successful business that overcomes without knowing what his competitor is up to. We are going to expose the competitor's plan for the world at this time over the next few minutes. Lindsay, thank you. Hallelujah. Father, we come in the name of Jesus today, in might and power, in the glory of God, to declare the victory of the Lord over Satan's master plan for the world.
Amen.
I bind unto myself today the strong name of the Trinity by invocation of the same, the three in one and one in three. I bind this today to me forever by power of faith, Christ's incarnation, his baptism in Jordan River, his death on cross for my salvation, his bursting from the spiced tomb, his riding up the heavenly way, his coming at the day of doom, I bind unto myself today. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, yala mama shando. Oh, yala makayanda. Oh, yala mayano. You see, in exposing Satan's master plan, we're here to set the captive free. We're here to move in glory, might, and dominion at such a pace. We're here to give the good news of the gospel. The men, women, and children can be saved from this master plan of the devil.
Mm-hmm.
And we here in Jesus' name can set them free from all the compliances which have occurred. You know, even the very DNA of bodies has been changed in line to the master plan. Yet there are those who can come to the Lord today and be reconstructed by him, be made whole by him, by whatever poison may have been given. You can be made whole today by the power of the living God. For we today are here to expose the master plan of the wicked one who has set up governments of this world to come together so as to bring in the new world order of Satan's Antichrist government for the last days before his second coming, his church having been raptured up at the beginning of the tribulation. Christ not coming to the earth, but Christ coming to the sky above the earth, and we, the church, being risen up to meet him in the air.
Yes.
I bind unto myself the power of the great love of cherubim, the sweet well done in judgment hour, the service of the seraphim confessors faith, apostles' word, the patriarch's press, the prophet's scrolls, all good deeds done unto the Lord, and purity of virgin virgin souls I bind unto myself today. The virtues of the starless heaven, the glorious sun's life giving way, the whiteness of the moon at even the flashing of the lightning free, the whirling winds, tempestuous shocks, the stable earth, the deep salt sea around the old eternal rocks. I'm not here today to give you all of Satan's plan. It is so vast, so large, that intellectually I don't think you could all take it in one go, but by the Spirit, day by day, we need to be aware of Satan's devices coming against the minds even of Christians. It being the Spirit that is born again, washed clean by the blood of the Lamb. But every day we go to a spiritual warfare of the mind, our mind needing transformed by the Spirit. And the old doctrine of Wesleyan sanctification needs to come in as we uphold the word of the Lord over our mind and start moving by the Spirit of God, so that our mind becomes in line with our spirits, that we start moving in this perfection as defined so clearly by the Apostle Paul in Ephesians 5. We being members of his body, flesh, and of his bones. In 1 Corinthians 6:17. We being one in spirit, the word declaring those joined to the Lord are one spirit. In 1 Peter, being partakers of his divine nature, being married to him, declared Jeremiah the prophet in his prophecy, chapter 3 and verse 14. And those led by the Spirit of God, Romans 8. They being the sons of God, and we move in this power and glory over Satan's dominion, he being the God of this world. Today we're not even going to touch the Garden of Eden, man deciding on that day to partake of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, not as if man has learned. Even today they turn to the scientists, they turn to the philosophers, they turn to the intellectual experts in time of plague. But instead, we need to understand as Christians there is a far higher power. That as the Israelites realized their sin and looked unto the type of Christ, so the plague was stayed. Yet there are those partaking of body-changing substances so as to apparently relieve them from this oppression. But I say to you today that we are the body of Christ. That those who attend to his words, even though 1,000 may fall at one side, 10,000 the other side, it does not come nigh the children of God who move in his power, move in his glory, move in his might, move in his dominion. We not being of those who eat of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, even returning to the Eden project, looking to pantheism as to a cure for the ills of this world, I say no. We have the Savior, we have the healer, we have the baptizer in the Holy Ghost, we have the soon coming King at our disposal, that whatsoever we shall bind on earth is bound in the heavenly realm. Whatsoever we shall loose on earth is loosed in the heavenly realm. I bind unto myself today the power of God to hold and lead, his eye to watch, his might to stay, his ear to hearken to my need, the wisdom of my God to teach, his hand to guide, his shield to ward, the word of God to give me speech, his heavenly host to be my God. Another part of Satan's master plan is what we've covered on many of our programs, to remove the word of God from the church. I guarantee that most of your so-called churches have scriptures that deny the Trinity, call Jesus a son of the gods, call Jesus as having not come as God in the flesh to this earth, who deny the resurrection as it relates to believers. We have covered this so many times. I refer you to our other Jesus course. You can find this online. The other part of Satan's plan has not only had man eat of the tree of knowledge and good and evil, but to partake of scriptures brought together in modern times by spiritualists Westcott and Hort, and have scriptures called NIV, RSV, NKJV, NASB, Amplified, the Message, and so forth, which deny the very Trinity of God. Oh, how Satan's master plan has been working on so many. And of course, we have had of late the majority of people partaking of Molech. We're not going into further detail of that, but we are saying to you today, make sure that what thou places in one body has not been sacrificed to another god. We also have Babylon at the ready. Babylon is there, ready to take over, take charge. Already Babylon has chosen to use bacterial warfare in what is a genuine third world war going on at the moment. Viral warfare, cyber warfare, cultural warfare. It is all there, all around us. But this is still not the key to Satan's plan. I'm telling you today, I have exciting scriptures before us, and the Lord is leading to me one now before as a leader to our principal scripture today. And I am so excited about this, for the word says that those who have been baptized into Christ have put on Christ, that there's neither Jew nor Greek, neither bond nor free, neither male, female, or those who are born again, washed by the blood of the Lamb. They are Christ. They are Abraham's seed. Christ having redeemed us from the curse of the law. We read this in verse 13 of Galatians 3, having been made a curse for us. And I am revealing today the key element of Satan's master plan. And this key element is in one word, compliance to the law. Mm-hmm. Compliance. In every aspect of life, there are far more regulations than are necessary so as to fulfill our calling, God. Everywhere we look, people are in fear. And this is Satan's master plan, to get humankind to comply. Have you fallen to this compliance, we ask today? Paul, in his second epistle to the Corinthians, declares, do we begin again to commend ourselves? How pride has come into so many ministries. We were saying in one of our courses being delivered before the program was released today, how people call themselves apostles and prophets yet have no idea of the calling of that particular vision of God. I can tell you this, that apostleship and prophethood is a calling, is an activity, rather than a title to lord it over others. For with this calling, these callings, comes such a high level of humility that pride can have no hold over us. And it's in these things that the devil, in his worldwide master plan, has brought about pride rather than humility, has brought about a false word of God, has brought about a situation where so many are in fear of regulation. Says the word of God, ye are our epistle, written in our hearts, known and read of all men. You see, Christ did not come to abolish the law. He came to fulfill it in his righteousness. And governments, banks, overseers of businesses and charities are moving in something so demonic. It is called the letter of the law. They give little heed to that which is of God, which is of heart ministry. For as much, said Paul, as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, referring to Ezekiel, who was looking to the day, not in tables of stone, but in fleshly tables of the heart. You see, Satan's master plan is to bring man under the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Satan's master plan is to take out the word of God. Satan's master plan is to get all of humanity to bow down to compliance. And in Cornwall, one of the major seats of witchcraft in the entire world, so the G7 has gathered without President Putin, so as to bring about the conditions for an order which is not of God, but using the lie of climate change to bring about further compliance to the letter of the law, knowing it is this that killeth. For they know not of the Spirit of God who brings liberty. For where the Spirit of God is, there is that glorious word liberty, which is coming against that word compliance. Liberty, liberty, I speak liberty and bind compliance to a new world order of decadence, which is seated in occultic ceremonies, which is seated under the sacrificial name of Molech, which most have partaken of. Now, that we, not that we are, sufficient of ourselves, declared Paul, to think anything as of ourselves. Our sufficiency is of God. My sword today is this Constitution of Great Britain held in my hand. The Queen, having agreed in 1953, at her coronation service, to uphold, inviolably uphold, the settlement, referring to the settlement of the first Elizabeth, who demanded every monarch as head of state as the first thing that he or she should do was to increase virtue in Christ's religion, increase the anointing, to repress errors, heresies, enormities, abuses, to conserve peace and tranquility. So today I bind in the name of Jesus all the aspirations of the G7 in Cornwall. I bind every one in the name of Jesus and bring forth the liberty of the Spirit that we should be able to stand against this end time master plan of Satan to hold people under bondage, so they be blinded, no longer having the word of God, relying on science, relying on philosophy, relying on the thoughts of man rather than the thoughts of God, not giving heed to going to church. They should be knocking down our door today to hear the word of the Lord. But I tell you this, I'm coming against you, Satan, today in the name above every name, that the men, women and children should be able to hear the word of the Lord. And I speak to the dry bones as Ezekiel spoke to them to come alive. Who hath made us able ministers? Not of the letter, but of the Spirit. For the letter killeth, the Spirit giveth life. Everything we have heard from governments over the last year has been of the letter of the law. Don't do this, don't do that, don't go out, stay in. And it's coming again. We don't know whether we're coming or going. But the people have complied, even to the point in Scotland of illegally the government had banned church meeting. Not it's against the law.
Yeah.
And we are here to proclaim that we have something far greater than letter compliance. That we are of the constitution of our nation. A constitution that declares the Spirit above the letter. For the Spirit giveth life. And you need to choose which day, which way you are going to go. Choose ye this day whom ye will serve. As for me, I will serve the Lord. Serving the Lord involves not complying to the master plan of Satan, but making a stand, not being afraid, as Daniel was not afraid of the decrees of Darius. We no longer are having laws made in Parliament, but rather decrees of government. And as Daniel stood, as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stood, so we stand today in the glorious name above every other name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow. And I am telling you this, there was something significant in the hymn which Pamela sung. At the name of Jesus every knee shall bow. And I bind this move of Satan, part of his master plan in the culture wars, to make footballers bend the knee to a foreign god. I bind the effect of this in the name of Jesus. And yes, we will be booing any bending of the knee. For it's only at the name of Jesus that every knee shall bow. Only at the name of Jesus every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And let me tell you this, it was evangelical Christians who scrapped the slave trade. It was evangelical Christians that reformed the British Empire, so as we should be kind and have a commonwealth of nations of equal partners, rather than have an empire-ridden government with people like Cecil Rhodes who would oppress the people. It was evangelical Christians like John Newton, William Wilberforce, like Lord Shaftesbury, who stopped the children from going up. It is only that which is of God, which can come against the master plans of Satan. And who was it that brought equal rights to America, to black, to brown, and to white people. It was an evangelical Baptist preacher called what was his name?
Martin Luther King.
Oh, praise the Lord. You see, there's a real attack on this meeting today. Martin Luther King and the National Baptist Church. Oh, how the Black Lives Matter movement portraying Marxism, portraying compliance, portraying that which is not of God, a hatred of God, to cancel Christianity. Well, I'm telling you this. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word of the Lord shall never pass away. You'll never cancel it. Today in Great Britain, at least we're having an opportunity to have a news channel which is not Marxist. Starting at 8 o'clock tonight is GB News, which we feel will bring us a more balanced point in relation to the news, for BBC and ITV and Sky News UK have been portraying a Marxist culture which is not of God, and we look for something different from GB News. But I'm telling you this today, that unless this nation gets on its knees, as King George VI called our nation to prayer of repentance, going back to the Second World War, that unless this nation decides to turn to God, it will endlessly be in the mire of lockdowns and compliance to the Molech God who has infected the bodies of the people that only Jesus Christ can set you free from us. Oh, how God is knocking on your door today. As Lindsay comes up and shares with me the final verses of St. Patrick's Breastplate. We know we are being called today. Then Pamela's coming along to sing And Can It Be. We are being called today to make this stand in the name of Jesus. Against the demon snares of sin, the vice that gives temptation force, the natural lust and war within, the hostile men and Michael's, or few or many powers in every place and in all hours against the fierce hostility. I bind to me these holy powers against all Satan's spells and wiles, against false words of heresy, against the knowledge that defiles, against the heart's idolatry, against the ways of evil craft, against the death wound and the burning, the choking wave, the poison shaft. Protect me, Christ, till thy returning. Christ be with me, Christ within me, Christ behind me, Christ before me, Christ beside me, Christ to win me, Christ to comfort and restore me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ in quiet, Christ in danger, Christ in hearts of all that love me, Christ in mouth of friend and stranger. I bind unto myself the name, the strong name of the Trinity, by invocation of the same, the three in one and one in three, by whom all nature hath creation, eternal Father, Spirit, word, praise to the Lord of my salvation. Salvation is of Christ the Lord. Hallelujah. For thus saith the Lord, I have given thee warning this day, that thou art to comply to the risen Christ, and not be moved as Daniel was not moved, not be moved as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were not moved. Not be moved as Paul and Silas were not moved. Mm-hmm. When chained in the prison, they praised the Lord. For I have called you, saith the Lord, to proclaim the constitution of thy nation, to proclaim the truth of my word, sworn upon by thy monarch in 1953. For thou hast bowed down to the lie of climate change, bowed down to the lie of the plague. For they tell you, you have not been redeemed by the curse of the law. But I tell you this, that my word is clear and cannot be come against. But I have called thee, saith the Lord, unto myself. I've called thee to walk the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, far above the master plan of Satan, far above the blindness of the God of this world, far above that which government would tell you to do. But I have called you, saith the Lord, to walk the heavenly places, to set the captives free, to hold down a hand to those who are in the mire, and bring them up to be with me. For I am come, saith the Lord, that ye may have life, and life in abundance. Lindsay, share with Amen. Us this wonderful hymn. Pam is going to sing, And Can It Be? And what this hymn means to you, because at one time you were in a Methodist church in Dundee, and there is an extra verse to this that is in not in the normal hymn books. Mm-hmm. And it goes, still the inward voice I hear. And it's this inward voice, us being led by the Spirit of God, that we are called to uphold today. Lindsay, just share a few moments on this wonderful hymn.
It is a wonderful hymn. Okay, dear viewers and listeners, I was finally, at the great age of about 35, born again in South Africa, because God led me there to the other side of the world by his wonderful plan. And when I came back to Dundee, Scotland, and I was in this Methodist church, the Lord led me to this Methodist church. And indeed, we were married, David and I, many years ago, 1985, in this lovely Methodist church. And of course, the great founder of the Methodist Church was God through John Wesley, John and Charles Wesley. And Can It Be, which Pamela is about to sing, is the most glorious hymn that makes people realize the sacrifice of blood that the Lamb of God, Christ Jesus our Lord, paid to set us free. And it talks about us being imprisoned in a dungeon of death and darkness. And suddenly this flame breaking through, and the dungeon flames with light. And all the shackles of the world, the dead world, the place of death and destruction, where the God of this world has been trying to hold us back, all these shackles miraculously fall off. I woke the dungeon flamed with light, and walking forth in the freedom of the Lord. And the extra verse too, which like so many other hymns have been cut short, and crucial verses have been left out. So listen and enjoy and take into your spirit this hymn.
angel marks inquire no more. 'Tis mercy, oh, let earth adore, let angel minds inquire no more. He left his father's throne above, so free, so infinite his grace, emptied himself of all but love, and bled for Adam's helpless race. 'Tis mercy, all immense and free, for oh my God, it found out me. 'Tis mercy, oh, immense and free, for oh my God, it found out me. Long my imprisoned spirit lay, fast bound in sin and nature's night. Thine eye diffused a quickening ray. I woke, the dungeon flamed with light. My chains fell off, my heart was free. I rose, went forth, and followed thee. My chains fell off, my heart was free. I rose, went forth, and followed thee. Still thee small inward voice I hear, that whispers all my sins forgive. Still the atoning blood is near, that quench the wrath of hostile hell. I feel the life his wounds impart. I feel the Savior in my heart. I feel the life his wound impart. I feel the Savior in my heart. No condemnation now I dread. Jesus and all in him is mine. Alive in him, my living head, and clothed in righteousness divine. Bold I approach the eternal throne, and claim the crown through Christ my own. Bold I approach the eternal throne, and claim the crown through Christ my own.
Bold I approach the eternal throne, and claim the crown through Christ my own. Bold I approach the eternal throne, and claim the crown through Christ my own. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Bold I approach the eternal throne, and claim the crown is my home. Father, we thank you for this time together around your word today. And as we have exposed the word of the Lord in relation to the activities of our defeated foe, we pray, Father, in Jesus' mighty name, that the truth of your word, that it is finished, be realized throughout this world. Oh, Father, we go around the world preaching the gospel, making disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, into the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, his death and his resurrection. We speak the word of the Lord. We speak it out. We have this sword which thou hast given us to come against all the evil wiles of the devil. And as so many people have been forced to comply, we pray, Father, that as we preach the liberty of the Spirit of God, we will see men, women, and children saved into the liberty of Christ Jesus. Oh, how we pray it, how we define it, this definition being that of spirits washed clean by the blood of the Lamb. This definition being of souls washed free by the waters of thy Holy Ghost, cleansing the innermost thoughts that we may be as thee on this earth, speaking out the word of the Lord wherever we may go. And this invitation today to come and join us here at Whithorn, Scotland, in this great mission to reach every creature with the gospel. Thou can see the 7-year plan at ecctv.org. And God has called us now into this last year of this plan to reach out like never before. And he is calling neighbors into the harvest, Father. We speak it out. Girls, continue to intercede. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Praise you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. We know, Lord, that the harvest is great, but the laborers are few. Even Lord Jesus, thy Son himself said to pray to the Father that he may send out laborers to that harvest. So we thank you, knowing, Lord, Father God, that thou art hearing our prayer today and preparing hearts to come and join in this great harvest of souls. You know who you are out there. Just answer the call. And it's such a great reward and a crown of glory waiting in heaven.
I believe that as people see what's going on in the world, I think more and more people will realise that really the majority of people have been, they've been worshipping the created rather than the creator, and then that they'll realise that they need to come back to him. So we need more people to come here and join us so that we can help those people who are convicted through the, you know, to come and hear and worship the true God, the one true God, the creator of heaven and earth and everything that we see, and including things that we can't see. And we have to remember that we are in this battle with things that we can't see, the word, the sword of the Spirit speaks about in Ephesians 6.
Yes, six. Our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and wicked spirits.
Yeah, so we need to be ready, and we need to fight against all these things, and we need more people to help us with that.
And we know we already have the victory that was won for us 2,000 years ago. Definitely. So it's so important for people to know and realize and learn who we are in Christ. As he is, so are we in this world, as his body and his end time church. Amen.
Amen. And may people see him in all of us. May they see Christ in us.
Bye for now. God bless you.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.